Welcome to Pulpy Tamarind Channel. Today we'll see how to make Aappam Batter. Hi, I am Pulpy Tamarind. I am a home cook by interest, hobby and passion. I am going to showcase authentic traditional recipes of Tanjavur district in Tamil Nadu, a state in India. Continental and North Indian recipes will also be showcased. All my recipes are uploaded in English, Hindi and Tamil languages. Please subscribe, share, like and comment. And press the bell icon for notifications of new recipes. Have you subscribed? Not yet? Please subscribe now. Aappam is usually had with coconut milk. So for this we require raw rice 1 cup, black gram 1/4 cup, crystal salt, cooking soda, fenugreek seeds 1 tablespoon. So we are going to take first 1 cup of raw rice. Which is heaped, so it's equivalent to 200 grams. We should not take it flattened, but we should take heap full of raw rice. So 200 grams of boiled rice, heap full, equivalent to raw rice. Now that also we've taken. Then the same measurement cup will take 1/4 black gram. So this is de-skinned black gram. So that is 1/4 cup. So 1:4. If we take 1 part of black gram, 4 parts should be boiled rice, 4 parts should be raw rice. And then we will take 1 tablespoon of fenugreek seeds. So this is what we require for making aappam. We will soak all of them in water and grind. So here we will mix both the rices together because we don't want it to be soaked separately. We will wash it and soak in water. Soak in water for 4 to 6 hours. So here we are grinding the raw rice and boiled rice, which we took 4 cups each and washed and cleaned and soaked for over 4 hours. So now we'll remove it from the water and grind it into a fine paste without any granules in it, or it should not be coarse at all. If you see that you feel it's coarse, then blend again till it is a fine paste. So add as little water as is possible. So the soaked water can be used for grinding purposes and also for thinning the batter. So don't throw it away, keep it aside, but we are not going to use the whole lot of it. We'll use what is required and the rest can be kept for thinning the batter once it's completely done. So till we are satisfied that the paste is totally fine, we need to keep blending it. So once we are done with this, we will blend the black gram, which is de-skinned and which has been soaked in water for more than an hour, which is clean washed and soaked in water for more than an hour, and also fenugreek seeds, a tablespoon of it, which has been soaked in water for more than an hour. So we have to grind all that into a fine paste and add to the rice batter. And once all the batter is blended and added, your aappam batter is near about ready. So now we will grind the de-skinned black gram, which was soaked for 2 hours, along with fenugreek seeds, which was also soaked for 2 hours, a tablespoon of fenugreek seeds. And the de-skinned black gram is also called as urad dal. So that is now in a blender, so we'll blend that also into a fine paste and add to the batter which has already been prepared, where we have blended the rice. So along with that, we'll mix this also up, and then we'll add a bit of salt, bit of cooking soda, and a bit of coconut milk, a bit of sugar, and mix it all well, and aappam batter is ready. So that's what aappam batter is all about. So now we will blend this de-skinned urad dal or black gram into a fine paste with as little water as is possible. So the mantra here is that it should not be a runny consistency. So whether it is the rice batter or the urad dal batter, it should not be running consistency. It should be a batter which should be for as good as for crepe or a pancake batter. So that's what you must remember. So finely grind it or blend it and mix it with the already blended rice paste, rice batter. That's it. Now we'll need to just mix it all well and add the other things to make it into a appam batter. So for that we'll add a teaspoon of sugar. Next we need to make coconut milk. For that we'll take a good coconut which is fleshy and sweet. We require coconut, cooking soda and salt and sugar for appam batter. We will break the coconut and remove the kernels and grind it. So we have removed the coconut kernel of a whole coconut and now we are blending it to make a fine grated coconut or desiccated coconut. We will remove it and do the same with the rest of the coconut kernels till we have blended all of them into desiccated coconut or grated coconut. That's the first step. And once we are done with that, we have to boil water into a lukewarm stage. We don't want very hot water. If it is warm or warm enough for us to touch the water, so that much heat is enough. So we need that water, only then we can make coconut milk. So we'll add a bit of water into the grated coconut and try to squeeze the milk out of it. So we need a sieve and a utensils under it. So now we have grated all of the coconut. We'll add a bit of water, that is the warm water, and then try to squeeze the milk out of the grated coconut. So that is trying to take out. If it is fresh coconut, you will get a lot of milk. But if the coconut is not that fresh, then, or if it is very mature, then you won't get much of milk. So using the water helps in getting the milk out of the coconut. So we'll squeeze the whole lot first, and then again blend it with a bit of warm water, and then try to squeeze again. So this process will be repeated 2 or 3 times. That is, we will squeeze grated coconut, all of them, with the help of a bit of warm water first. And once all of them have been squeezed, we will again blend it with a bit of hot water, and then again squeeze water out of it. And again we do the process repeatedly till there's no milk from the coconut which has been grated. So till that stage we'll repeat the process again and again. So what comes out of this is called coconut milk. So coconut milk is actually aided with the help of warm water so that we can release or squeeze or press the whole lot of coconut milk out of the grated coconut. So this is what we are doing here. So this is a repeat process. So the first time the milk comes out is called the first milk, and the second time when it's done a bit watery, that is the second milk, and third time it's supposed to be third milk. So when you have a very nice very fresh very matured coconut which is not over matured, we get a lot of milk. But if the coconut is very tender or if it is over matured, we will not be able to get a lot of milk. So whatever milk we get, we have to add, we can't add a lot of water and make it watery, then it won't have the coconut milk taste. So this is what we are going to do. If you want more, you have to add more coconut. Instead of one coconut, you can add 2 coconuts. That's the only thing you can do. We can't add more water. So for this, we have added about 1 glass of 200 ml of warm water. That's all we have to heated up, but we are not going to add the whole lot. We'll only add what is required. So see the milk down, that is thick milk which has come out of the coconut without adding much water, only to remove the milk or to help or aid in making the milk we have added water. So this is the thick sweetened coconut milk which is going to be used, one ladle into the appam batter and the rest over the appam after it is cooked. So you should select a big coconut so that we can get a lot of milk, or select more than one coconut if you think it won't be enough at the preparation stage itself. And now you can see that we are blending the squeezed coconut remains with water, warm water, and trying to take out as much milk as is possible. So after doing that, we'll again squeeze it, and the milk will totally come out. And once it's done, the remaining husk or whatever is remaining can be used for garden purposes, or you can throw it because it's of no use anymore. So we are using the last part of the warm water to remove as much milk as is possible. So till it the milk comes, we'll use it, and once it runs dry or you just get water, then you are not going to use it anymore. That's the end of the coconut. So the milk that we get from here is we'll be adding sugar to it and cardamom powder to it so that it becomes very tasty. And we are going to use a spoonful or ladleful of it, or two ladlefuls of it, into the aappam batter for taste, and the rest we will add once the aappams are made. So this is a very tasty affair and also very heavy. These are usually done on Sundays or holidays when you can relax a bit after having a heavy breakfast. So we are squeezing out the last of milk, and I think that's it. Milk is done. So now we are removing. The second time is over, and again third time will be done. So again add warm water and try to remove as much as is possible. So this is the way coconut milk is removed or made from coconut. But the choice of coconut is very important here. The kernel should be thick and fleshy, and it should be fresh and juicy. If it's very tender, then you won't be able to remove, get milk out of it. If it is very mature, then it will only have a coconut oil smell, but milk will be less. So this is a very important point where choice of coconut is done. So people who are dealing with coconut know very well which is a good coconut for you. So when we buy, we usually tell and buy that we are going to buy a coconut for this purpose, so give me a correct coconut from the coconut seller. So that's the way we buy. Otherwise, if you just buy any coconut, it may be of not much help if it is not of the right choice. So that's all, folks. So third part of milk also has been done. So this is the consistency. Check this out, and this is the way you have to remove the milk. All the three parts are the same. So next we will prepare the aappam batter. So already we have the rice batter and the urad dal batter, or the black gram batter, which we are mixing very well. And to that, now we will add a bit of one ladle full of coconut milk that we just now made. So we'll add that for taste and mix it into the batter. So that's it, a ladle of coconut milk. We'll start mixing it into the batter, and we need the batter to be of the right consistency. So if you need to make it more thin, we need to add more water. So now we'll add the cooking soda, half a teaspoon, so that we can aerate it and also make it soft. So there's no time for fermentation here. We just now finished making the batter, and immediately we're going to make aappams. So we are adding cooking soda for the same. And so also this is the salt part of it. Half a teaspoon of sugar. This sugar part of it, we are adding sugar, and then we'll add salt. So this much salt should be enough. This is crystal salt. And now we added everything. Let's just mix it all well, and add the water which is remaining from grinding rice and black gram into a fine paste. We can add that water if we want to make it more liquid. So this is very important that the consistency is right. So you can add some more water if you think it's thick enough. So the aappam batter should be of the right consistency for making the aappams. So we can start making the appams once we are confident that the batter is fine. Look at how white the batter is, and that's the consistency. So we can go ahead and make appams. So now we are going to add sugar to the coconut milk and cardamom powder to enhance its taste and sweeten it. So we are adding sugar here, about 6 to 7 tablespoons of sugar to the coconut milk, and we'll add a pinch of cardamom powder, and we'll dissolve the sugar, and it's ready for serving with appams or over the appams. So we make pancakes and pour maple syrup over it, similarly we make the appams and pour the coconut milk over it and sprinkle some sugar. So now we are going to make an appam. We usually have a special kadai for that, which is well seasoned and it doesn't stick. So first we will oil it a bit. Then we'll just pour a ladle of the appam batter and hold the kadai and swirl the batter so that it becomes like appam. So from where it starts, it should come and end at the same place. So we have to swirl like that and keep it back on the gas and cover it. And so now we have to keep checking it. And whenever you remove the cover, you'll see that it's browning from the sides and lifting up away from the kadai. But we have to wait till the whole of the center is also cooked, which should not be raw at the center. And also there's a sound which comes, a zinc sound, which helps you in recognizing that the appam is done. So now it's easy to lift. There's no oil applied over the appam. Only you just wipe the kadai with the help of a tissue or a cloth, and then you start pouring the batter and swirling around and covering it up, and then removing it straight after it's done. There's no oil at all involved here, and it's not flipped on both the sides and cooked. It's only cooked on one side. So this is appam and served with coconut milk. Tasty appam with coconut milk is served. Coconut milk poured over the appam and sugar sprinkled on it. Authentic way of eating a appam is lavishly pouring coconut milk over it and sprinkling sugar over it. Thank you for watching Pulpy Tamarind Channel.